Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for joining me for this week's Just Ask Jay. And on this week's Just Ask Jay, it's all about grounded spirits. And have they been bad spirits? I'm not sure, but I'm going to tell you, if you don't know what a grounded spirit is after today, well, then you're going to have to let me know because I'm hoping that I'll do a good job. Great questions from Tina and from Marty Sue. Now, Tina wrote, I heard a lot of people passing and not knowing that it's happened and that they stay stuck. And, what do you think of this? I'm getting married next year, but things don't feel right because there's going to be some important people in my life that are missing. I just wish that I knew in some way that they're going to be there on my very special day. You know what, Tina? I'm going to tell you, I believe that they're going to be there on your special day. But, when we talk about people not knowing when they passed away and if they stay grounded, it's a little bit different than being a grounded spirit. There's different levels of types of spirits, let's say. There's visiting spirits, there's grounded spirits, there's residual energy, there's trapped energy. I mean, I could go on forever. But I think what you're talking about is those who don't realize that they've passed away and they're kind of stuck in limbo a little bit. So I do believe that that can happen. Absolutely. People that die of violent deaths, people that, get hit from behind and don't realize that they've died, that kind of thing is so quick that they are here one moment and instantly transform to the other side the next without even feeling a thing. And not remembering passing because there's not one spirit that remembers dying. They all know they're dead or they have an idea that they're dead. So what happens is after a person transforms through immediately, they have sort of like a 3-day period in human time because there's no time measurement on the other side. But in human days, I would say about 3 days or so before they realize that they've actually passed away. Most people experience seeing their loved ones on the 3rd or 4th day of their passing. And that's why most people believe that that's kind of when they start to wake up to their passing. Now, some of them are surprised that they've died. Oh my God, I can't believe. Like, am I in a dream? Am I dead? Like, what the hell's going on? But I'm going to tell you, when they realize that they're gone, they will go through that light unless they don't have a belief system. And I've seen that happen an awful lot. I have some friends that are light workers who help spirits go through the light because either there's an unacceptance of their passing, so they won't accept that they've passed away, or they won't accept that that light is something that they need to go through because they don't believe in that light. So sometimes they have spirits that are like that. Sometimes there's spirits that are afraid to go through the light or don't believe that there's really anything on the other side because their belief system was much of the same on this earth. They didn't think that there was heaven on the other side. They didn't think that there was God. They didn't think that there's anything like that. No belief systems, purely black and white. That's it. That's all. What you see is what you get. But I'm going to tell you, every spirit does eventually go through, even those that are grounded. Now, I believe that you're going to see your loved ones because I don't think that you have any grounded spirits whatsoever, Tina. And I clearly feel that all of your loved ones have progressed through the other side, clearly gone through the light, clearly transformed, whether they've had this experience of dying quickly or not. But I'm going to tell you, Marty Sue has a little bit of a different situation, which I thought was interesting, because it also talks of grounded spirits. Now, Marty Sue writes, Hi, Jay. I heard when someone dies, they must feel all the pain that they've caused others before they can be fully accepted into heaven. Is that true? And I'm going to tell you, what, Marty Sue? I don't believe that to be true. I believe that it depends on what kind of passing you've had, what the circumstances were. Of course, there's so many different things that could happen when someone passes. But, when someone dies, if they've caused someone a lot of pain, they do need to revisit their karmic lessons. So, in other words, they have to stand in their shoes as well as the shoes of others to see how it is that they had an effect on that person's life. Now, don't forget, before coming onto this earth, we make agreements with other souls to go through certain life experiences. And sometimes they're not the greatest ones, Marty Sue. Sometimes, it could be that you had this experience with John, that you had a very turbulent type of relationship, as you mentioned here, that he caused you, to endure a lot of pain during your life with him, and that he that you believe that he may still be grounded because he's not accepted responsibility on the other side. But I don't believe that. Suicides and those spirits that are fully grounded are usually because they've taken their own life, they've broken their agreement. Now, there's five exits to a soul passing to the other side. So in other words, there's five ways that we pick on how to die in this lifetime. Suicide's not on the how-to list of dying. Absolutely not. So what happens is if someone commits suicide, they, I believe, stay stuck in limbo a little bit in between realms until they've stepped into everybody's shoes that they've had an effect on in this lifetime to see how their death has affected them. Because the thing is, they weren't supposed to kill themselves to begin with. So, example, if I'm supposed to be married to someone and we were supposed to have three children, but I come home and he's committed suicide because he thought that I did something behind his back, let's say. Now, I'm not going to have the three children that I was supposed to have with him. I'm not going to go through the life lessons that I chose to go through with him as my soulmate. So what happens is, let's say he passes now, I'm stuck here left behind, not having the three children I was supposed to have, not going through the sex, drugs, and rock and roll, let's say, experience that I was supposed to go through with these children, tough love, this, that. And so I'm not learning about patience and understanding the way I was supposed to. Instead, my entire life and my entire path is now changed. So now I'm faced, going down a road with perhaps never getting married because I don't trust, that situation. For me, love equals suicide. Never want to get married. Oh my God, that kind of thing. So, so that soul will stay grounded until it's learned exactly what it was supposed to and not supposed to do, and then it clearly goes through the other side. Now, if it has difficulty crossing through, it's most likely 9 times out of 10 someone comes to get them from the other side. So a mom, a dad, a grandmother, that kind of thing. But they are never, never left in between limbo or in between worlds very long. So they have to stay there long enough to accept that responsibility. But the thing is, you're still feeling the pain, Marty Sue. And because you're still feeling the pain doesn't mean that John is going through those karmic lessons or revisiting those lessons on the other side. I believe that you're going through that pain because you're grieving and because you love them so much, but you're having a difficult time accepting the pain that he's inflicted on you. So humanly, we're much, much different than souls. Once he gets to cross through the light, and once he's not, stuck in between realms, let's say if he did commit suicide in his example, I would think that that soul would definitely cross through to the other side. I think that that soul would no longer harbor any guilt, any pain. He wouldn't feel sorry for you crying. He wouldn't feel bad for the human emotions that you're experiencing because he would understand that you're having human emotions. You have to understand that, once a soul goes through, it doesn't have human qualities anymore. So it doesn't have an ego. It doesn't experience pain or suffering on a human level anymore. So it kind of lets all of that go. So I don't think that John is, kind of stuck. I don't think that he's felt all the pain that he's inflicted on others, but I believe that through his journey on the other side, he will have to revisit some of these lessons and some of these experiences that he's had with you to revisit karmically what it was that he was supposed to learn from that, because agreements were made before the two of you came into being. And this could be that you chose this kind of life with this man, for whatever reason, to make you stronger, to help other people. I'm not sure. But I believe that everything is predetermined and that we do have the power to change that while we're here. But I believe that that's what you lived with, John. I want to thank you both, Tina and Marty Sue, so much, for opening up the door to grounded spirits. It's absolutely a wonderful topic. And I'm going to tell you that not all spirits are grounded. If there are suicides that were very, very traumatic or difficult or drug-induced, or someone is not really of the right frame of mind, they are always safe. So I don't want people out there thinking that those that they love so much are suffering in between worlds. It's simply just souls path to the other side, and the way that a soul does learn before it becomes brilliant, before it expands and grows into such a big and loving and euphoric being. So I don't want you guys worrying about your loved ones on the other side. They're always so happy and at peace. I want to thank you so much for this week's questions, and please keep on asking if you have any questions about all kinds of things about the afterlife, paranormal, and such. If you're looking for messages from the other side, please visit Your Message from Spirit at my Infinity Fan Club at mediumjlane.com. I love you all so much. Have a great day. Bye-bye.